Hey all, and you're probably wondering, why am I not doing the Last of Us video at the moment? Because I wanted to get this video out first. Basically, it's been exactly a year since I got my first sprite set, so I wanted to go back through the history of the sprite sets that I've had over the last year and show you some concept art, including a design that almost became Fuchsia's first design, but we went with a different one. So yeah, we'll start with that. So basically, the person who's drawn a majority of my sprites and a majority of any concept art that I've had for sprites has been my friend Erica. She lives over in the UK, she's awesome. I've told you guys to support her in the past, but yeah, so initially I was looking for a design for a mascot for a different channel, and she drew up these two. She drew up a trap and just a regular girl, and at the time I just kind of went with, okay, let's do the trap, and it ended up becoming the design for Fuchsia Butter. Went through a few stages, and then we initially came out with the finished sprites. I still have a soft spot for the other design, though, and some way or another I would like to see it return someday. And now to move on to the spooky one of the bunch. So, first of all, we decided to just iron out a basic thought-up design at first, and we came up with this, but we didn't like the color scheme too much because it was just a bit too orange, so Erica took the initiative and came up with this. And then, I thought I lost this picture, but I actually found it. This is a picture of what the sprites look like before they have any of the facial structure details added. So no eyes, no mouth, and lack some of the shading there too. It's not really important, it's just cool that I found that. So then we started coming up with poses, and then we came out with the finalized Halloween ones. And these were really fun, even though I only used them in like two or three commentary videos in October, because for some reason last October I was obsessed with making constant Gmod videos.
Unga bunga changa bunga!
Oh, by the way, if you guys haven't watched that, I have a playlist for all my Gmod videos. They're fun. You'll notice that they take a lot of inspiration from Breezy. And now, onto the one that you're all familiar with. That isn't this one. The one that I usually use, the 2020 sprite set. So initially, the first idea that we came up with basically was just using longer hair and removing the hat from the original, making it look a bit more elegant, a bit more professional. And this is the first rough sketch we got of it. Looked pretty nice, very clean, very pretty. And then we doubled down on a basic design, and we tried to figure out what we were gonna do. We had multiple color schemes, we chose the one in the middle, the one that you're all familiar with, and then we edited it a bit, removing the suspenders, just changing them into bra straps, and then just slightly altering the colors and figuring out how we were gonna do the earrings and the clip and the freckles and everything there. We moved forward with that, figuring out the blending for the hair, and then we finished up coming out with the one that you all know of now. This sprite set is, I love it. I absolutely love this set. It's so good, and I am going to try to make sure that the 2021 set is just as good. And now for the stills done by NerdyArty on Instagram. When Erica was having personal issues, I needed to find someone else to do two seasonal sprite sets. So those two were obviously the April Easter ones and the current July 4th ones that I'm just using for the entirety of July. So I found them on Instagram, and then I hit them up, and we started working on the basic pose and design for Bunny Butters, and this is what we came up with sketch-wise. I kept saying, make her thicker, throughout the whole process. And after the sketching was done, we moved on forward and started working on the faces or whatever. The sketch got cleaner and cleaner, and then we got the line art done. And then we came out on top with the finalized color for Bunny Butters. Her skin was actually too white in the end, and the only other problem I have with these stills is that they weren't sexy enough, I guess. But then the July ones changed that. Similar process as before, but before we started, I established that we would be definitely giving the sprite a sort of cartoony hourglass sex appeal shape, and it seems to be working because you guys are going nuts for it. So yeah, we started with the basic sketch. I told her, like, the shawl that McCree has, and she came up with that.
and then we moved on with the faces, and then the line art, and then we came out with what you see right now.
So yeah, that's basically just the history of all my sprites that I have. No, I wasn't gonna forget to talk about you. As you guys all know, I had a contest between a bunch of different art submissions for the design for Lubot, the side character that I'm gonna end up using in my videos, and this is Lubot.